Urinary tract infections are extremely common. Around 1 in 2 women and 1 in 20 men will get a UTI in their lifetime. Plus, once you've had one UT challenge, you're way more susceptible to another in the future. That's why you just need Just Thrive's UT123. This product can actually prevent UTIs while maintaining your urinary tract health. UT123 targets both immediate and long-term relief. We've all heard to drink cranberry juice for your urinary tract, but did you know that for the full effects, you need the whole cranberry? Not just juice, but the skin, flesh, and even the seeds. Well, UT123 uses superior ingredients that utilizes the whole fruit. This supplement truly is the full package. So if you're someone who struggles with the constant urge to urinate, a burning feeling when you pee, pelvic pain, or just want to be proactive in your urinary health, Just Thrive is for you. Just Thrive is so confident you'll love their product that there is a 100% money-back guarantee on every purchase made through justthrivehealth.com. And for a limited time, you can save 20% off site-wide at justthrivehealth.com with promo code SEXWITHEMILY. That's justthrivehealth.com and use code SEXWITHEMILY for 20% off your order. You're going to love it. Listen, alcohol is just out in 2024. There is a rising trend of going alcohol-free or being sober curious, and alcohol, the truth is, it's just bad for you and can famously impair your sex life. So if you're looking for another way to unwind, relax, or just have fun, I cannot recommend Viya's THC gummies enough. Viya has gummies for every occasion. Whether it's to improve your sleep, I love their sleep gummies, I take them everywhere, your mood or your focus. They even have an aphrodisiac gummy called High Love to boost my arousal levels. High Love has a unique blend of cannabinoids and aphrodisiac exotic herbs that are known for their libido enhancing effects. So I've been using Viya for a while now, and I absolutely love them. They're a super trusted company. They use premium hemp, natural ingredients, and they're known for their premium indoor THCA flower. All their products are made here in the US. They got quick and discreet shipping to all 50 states so you can all enjoy them, not to worry. And also super affordable. So head over to viahemp.com and use code EMILY at checkout to save 15% off your order. That's viahemp.com. Use code EMILY at checkout for 15% off your order and let me know what you think.
Look into his eyes. They're the eyes of a man obsessed by sex. Eyes that mock our sacred institutions. Bedroom eyes, they call them in a bygone day.
Hey, Emily, you got a boyfriend?
Because my man E here, he just got his heart broken. He thinks you're kind of cute.
A girl's got to have her standards. Oh, my.
Do women know about shrinkage?
Isn't it common knowledge?
What do you mean, like laundry? It shrinks?
Can we not talk about sex so much?
Are you kidding me?
Oh, my God. That feels so good.
Being bad feels pretty good.
But you know, Emily's not the kind of girl you just play with.
You're listening to Sex with Emily. We're talking about sex, relationships, and everything in between. For more information, go to sexwithemily.com, where you will get all your sex questions answered, and you'll be very entertained.
And you'll get laid. And automatically. You'll get laid. Automatically.
Maybe if we did that dial a star thing.
Yes. See, you got to do it.
I know. There's some website. I just walked in the studio. A man was showing me. What's it called? Dial a star?
Yeah, it's dial-a-star.com.
And like...
TMZ was just talking.
Not that
about
I'm
it.
A star for reals, but you could call me and talk. But if would you pay $10 an hour, we could have a great a minute.
$10 a minute. Like some of these people are making thousands of dollars an hour. It's crazy.
Wow, that's crazy. But don't you think we'd have a good chat? So maybe I should do it if you guys all want to talk to me. I mean, I would talk to you for free, but it'd be nice to make a living at some point. Okay, so today's show, our guest is Barbie Davenporte. She's a writer for the Village Voice Media sex blog, AfterDarkLA.com, and she's going to talk about sex toys that she loves and embarrassing sex stories. So apparently she's got these really embarrassing, crazy sex stories, and she's going to share with us. She's a writer. She's hilarious. We've read all of her stuff.
Cool.
Isn't that awesome? And we're going to answer your emails, and we're going to do sex in the news, and we're just going to have a blast.
I want to know if she can actually make money writing a blog. That's my interesting
question. Yeah, you can ask her
question.
That.
Because, I mean, I write blogs for work, but, you know, there's a lot more things that I have to do. So, I mean, right. I actually get paid to do blogs, but solely, I want to know if you can make a living being a blogger.
Yeah, it's hard. It's hard to do. I mean,
but if she has juicy stories, I'm sure she's getting some site
traffic.
Yeah,
she's got some good stories. Exactly. So, we're going to talk about that. And then, Kelsey
and
I...
It's very Sex in the City.
What? To be a sex blogger?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. I guess people say that I'm like Sex in the City with my sex podcast.
Yeah.
I mean, we blog.
Totes.
Not, totes, man. It's totally like that.
When are you going to start hooking up with, like, some really rich guys so I can go on lavish trips and stuff like that? See, that's very Sex in the
City. Soon.
Please.
No, honey, I promise. I'll take you. I'll take you with me. You're coming up with me when next time.
I want to go somewhere.
Yeah, you just got to look at their watch, they say.
Private thing. But my watch is very – this watch fools you. I'm wearing a watch right now that I picked up at Nordstrom's. And people who have millions of dollars that I've run into say, oh, my God, that's such an awesome watch.
Who makes it?
I bought this watch for $20 at Nordstrom's, and it's called the label is titanium, and they're like, oh, my God, that's such a nice watch.
That is a nice watch.
$20.
A stripper told me once, who was on the show, that
strippers probably really know watches.
Yeah, they look at guys' watches, and that's how they know if they're going to get the big bucks. So if you are going to a strip club and you want a stripper's attention, just wear a really nice watch.
Who cares about
that's
getting strippers'
attention? That's what I'm
saying.
Some guys do want strippers' attention.
That's
speaking
a waste
of strippers,
of money, guys.
We're going to Vegas. I told you that.
Yeah.
Do you go to strip? You don't go to strip clubs when you're there, do you?
Hell no.
We're not probably going to do that.
But they are the best talkers ever.
In Vegas?
Ever.
I know, so much money.
I went with the old boss one time, and he gave myself and his brother $3,000 each because we're going to go strip clubbing all night. And I was like, man, I'm going to hold on to this $3,000. Right. Like, there's going to be no.
Yeah, you're like, yeah, see you at the strip club. Yeah,
I'm just going to like. But like, the strippers there are like top notch quality, like professional talkers. Like,
right.
They'll put in the time and they'll get the money out of you.
Yeah, that's true. So how much did you come home with?
I ended up coming home with like $1,500. I ended up spending like $1,500 just like throwing money everywhere. And like, but a lot of it was because you can drink in strip clubs there.
Right.
So a lot of it was drinking and stuff like that.
You can drink at strip clubs here, can't you?
No. You can drink at strip clubs here in San Francisco.
When they don't get naked.
When they don't get fully naked. They can get topless but not completely naked. But if you want to go to ones where they're completely naked, you cannot drink.
Right.
And
it's
funny because one time I thought the laws changed for some reason because I was sitting at a strip club. I brought some of my interns with me and I was showing them a good time. I wasn't really into it. And then the cocktail waitress comes by and she goes, would you like a beer? I go, a beer?
Because I would like a beer.
Yeah, because the women in front of me were fully nude. I was like, I don't believe I could get a beer. So I get the beer. She brings it to me, and I drink it. It was the nastiest thing I ever drank in my life, and I was like, what is this? It was non-alcoholic beer.
Oh, why don't they tell you that?
She didn't tell me. See, you can't trust them.
Can't trust them. That's so funny, but I don't know. We're talking about Vegas. We're so excited. Kelsey's never been, and we're going for this conference.
I know. Oh, my
God.
What are you
going
to do?
I don't know. Your friends are going to hook us up.
Yeah, I already tweeted you guys. Oh, I've hooked up one of our interns in the past. She had an amazing time.
Right.
So make sure you guys follow through.
We will follow through.
I know how you guys are.
We're trying to plan our outfits on the way over here. Because, like, how sexy, slutty, like, is it every night people in Vegas are going out crazy?
Oh, every night people are going out.
Like, Monday is like a Friday.
Yeah. Every single night. You should really hook up with one of my friends, DJ Greg Lopez. He's a really cool guy.
Okay, cool.
I put him on the tweets with you guys. He's not as active on Twitter, so it might take you a while to.
All right.
But let me know if he does get in touch with you.
Anyone else going to be in Vegas next week? Let us know. We'll be there Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
I know. That's crazy. And we've been trying to plan for years for us to go. You plan a trip without me again.
You go all the time without me, Menace. But we'll do it. Maybe we should do a show from there. Bring our little recorder
I would love to do that.
You can come.
Yeah,
you got a job.
I'm actually going again soon, probably in April, but you can't come with me then.
Why? Why? Oh, I can't come with you, but you are mad at me?
No. I'm just, you don't.
I'm fun. What?
Yeah, you are fun, but it's just going to be different groups of friends, and we're going to go places you're not going to
want
to go.
Friends. You don't think I'd like your friends? Or they
no,
like me.
No, I'm sure.
That's cool.
I'm sure it would be a great time, but it's just like we would probably go places that you would
like,
not
like. Where
be
would
into.
You go that I wouldn't want to go?
We would probably go to like really. Well, I suggested the other day. I was like, oh, if you go to Vegas, you got to go to the gun store and go shoot guns. You're like, I don't want to do that. That's something that we do every time we go there.
I changed my mind.
Oh, you changed your mind.
I want to go gun shooting. I do. Kelsey, do you want to go gun shooting? Yes.
Yeah,
okay, we're
going to
shoot guns.
Now, let me break something down real quick with the gun shooting.
Break it down.
I know there's people who are a lot anti-guns. I am not a gun owner. I don't want to go buy guns or go shoot them. But it's in controlled environment, okay?
Right.
And it's funny because every time I go there and we'll have like some females with us, they don't want to go. They're like, oh, it's going to be too loud and all this stuff. But the moment you hand a woman a gun, like a handgun, and they start shooting it, they go crazy.
Really?
They love it. They
That's
get, like,
awesome.
Super, they
is
get
it
super
right on the
honer.
Strip? The gun store?
It's like a block off the strip.
Okay. I haven't been to Vegas in like years, probably 5 years, six
yeah,
years. Has changed, probably changed a lot.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's totally like revamped in the middle of the strip where there's a ton of places. My favorite hotel ever, Cosmopolitan. You got to go there.
Okay.
Amazing food, amazing drinks.
Everywhere is amazing food and drinks, I feel.
Yeah,
no, there's
but,
not the shady, sketchy places,
yeah,
but
yeah.
there's like you, some amazing.
Yeah. You kind of don't want to go towards the Mirage and Treasure Island, unfortunately, because those used to be really awesome, but it smells like a sewer over there.
Oh, now. Really?
Yes,
good to know. You got to give us more tips before we go.
Okay.
Smells like a sewer, Kelsey. Write that down. But we're going for the ILS. It's the International Lingerie Show. And then we'll mm-hmm. be – and there's a lot of sex toy people there and all that stuff. So
cool.
we're going to meet all them and have a good time. So I've got a little bit of sex in the news for you.
What do you got for
I
me?
Love the first story because I can totally relate. No vibrators required. Women have orgasms at the gym. Ladies, if you've yet to fulfill your New Year's resolutions to work out, here's another reason to hit the gym. You might just have an orgasm. Kinsey found out in 1953 that at least 5% of women climax during workouts. But recent research at University of Indiana showing the number may be higher. Survey showed that of women whose orgasm, 45% orgasm after multiple sets of crunches in what is known as a coregasm.
A coregasm.
20% experience pleasure on the exercise bike, 10% for climbing, lifting weights, running, blah, blah, blah. Okay, here's the deal. I told you this years ago, but because we've been talking about this in a while. But
no, you haven't told me.
I used to have orgasms at the gym all the time.
No way,
and
you're
I'm
lying.
So pissed that I can't anymore. I actually look at this machine fondly, and it's the one where you put your legs down and you spread them open.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm talking
yeah.
about? The thigh, the
oh,
thigh
yeah,
machine,
yeah, yeah.
And you can do it reverse, like you, mm-hmm. you push out with your thighs and. I would have an orgasm every single time, like every morning, and it was mm-hmm. amazing, but it doesn't happen anymore. And I'm pissed. I look at the machine. I'm like, oh, it's like an ex-boyfriend.
Yeah,
like, I don't even want to do it anymore.
We had such great times.
We had such great times at the gym. But it is kind of, it says that women are embarrassed. Many of the women surveyed actually expressed some kind of embarrassment. I'm not embarrassed. I'm psyched to have an orgasm at the gym. My gay gym, no one would pay attention.
Maybe that's why you're at the gay gym.
No,
and
this was
the...
years ago at my straight gym.
Yeah, but... You said it doesn't happen now. Maybe
no,
because
it hasn't
maybe,
happened in years.
But maybe the workout equipment is just not into women.
I think my
That's
body
why.
Changes. Yeah, exactly, exactly. No one at that gym's into women. They look at me like I'm dirt. No, just kidding. I'm just not. It's nice, actually, the gay gym, because no one cares about me. Okay, so Chloe and Lamar are on the rocks.
No!
Did you see this coming? Menace, first the sex swing, now the marriage. Everything is falling apart for Khloe Kardashian and
people
Lamar
People just
Odom.
Wanted to fall
I know.
Apart.
People
it.
Are just want everyone to be unhappy, which is so stupid. Mm-hmm. Sources say Lamar is furious that Khloe refused to socialize with the Mavericks players and their wives, even bailing or getting involved with charities connected to the team. Whether this diva behavior comes from her being a diehard Lakers fan or a diehard narcissist is anyone's guess. So he's pissed that she won't talk to the basketball
I
wives.
Don't believe it. Don't believe it.
Okay. You think they're happy?
I'm sure there are a lot of adjustments moving to a new city
yeah.
and stuff like that. And then she's used to having her family around all the time. But I don't believe that she's
been on the
being
rocks.
A diva and stuff like that. I
she
honestly
kind of
don't.
Is a diva though, right?
No. I mean, she's very outspoken,
right?
But I don't believe she would
okay.
be
that's
a diva.
That's our Kardashian story for the day. Okay, Leonardo
DiCaprio.
Now,
if this was about Kim Kardashian, maybe.
Right. I was seeing that I was reading that she was dating Kanye West.
Amber Rose, who's Kanye West's ex-girlfriend, says that that is true, that that's the reason that they broke up was because of Kim Kardashian.
Yeah, he said they say he's in love with her. I read at the gym this morning. So we'll see what happens. That could be
it's funny because they're not really public about it. She's very public about everybody that she's dating, but for some reason – not about Kanye West.
Yeah, the story said that
weird.
He was in love with her and he'd do anything to get her to marry him. Why would you want to marry her? Seriously. She's already been married 3 times. Didn't work very well.
Yeah, I don't think he... But I see Kanye West as somebody keeping her in line.
Yeah, he's got his own stuff going on too.
Yeah,
he's
Kanye
really
West, he's very strong-headed.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay.
And that's actually... People always ask me, if you could interview anybody in the world, who would you interview? And I would say Kanye West.
Why?
Because I feel that I understand why he is the way he is.
Which way? In which way?
People will say, you know, he's very arrogant and,
right.
you know, he does all this stuff. He's very cocky. He's into himself. And I believe the reason that he is that way is when he was coming up and trying to be famous and trying to be a rapper, no one gave him a chance. Like, People signed him to the label just to make beats for other rappers and stuff like that. They didn't really want him to come out with an album. They didn't believe in him. So when he became a success, now he's like, look at me now. Look at me now. No one believed in me. Look at me now. You know?
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's the reason why he is today.
Okay. Well, that's happens to a lot of celebrities. They don't make it. They don't make it. And then they make it.
Yeah. But I think that he still holds on to that a lot.
Right.
And then that's why he comes off.
So you're going to break it down with Kanye West when you get to interview him.
And I'll see if he
just say, dude, I feel your pain. I understand you. Is that what you're going to say to him?
No, I'm going to be like, this is why I think you act the way you do. And tell me if I'm right or
okay.
not. And see what he has to say.
See what happens. All right.
But I don't think it'll ever happen because he doesn't really do interviews.
He doesn't?
No, unless you're like super famous.
Okay. Well, I'll work on that for you. Leonardo DiCaprio is a bit of a stinker, says Gal Pal. In his bid to save the planet, Leonardo DiCaprio is apparently causing quite a stink by only showering a few times a week, refusing to wear deodorant, which he considers unnatural, and letting recyclables pile up in his kitchen. He's not only turning green, he's turning off his model girlfriend, Erin Heatherton. Sources say she's warned him to be more hygienic, but his love for Mother Earth may win out in the end.
Yeah, yeah.
Guys gotta wear deodorant.
I know people like this.
I do too. It's tough. It's a men smell if they don't wear deodorant.
Yeah, and it's
you
just
can wear the natural deodorant. Doesn't really work.
That doesn't work at all.
I know, but at least it's something.
Oh man, yeah, it's hard because they're like, oh, I don't want to put chemicals on my body, but what do you do?
I use
because
so many chemicals. I'm not that uptight. People are crazy. Yeah.
Can you smell what I'm smelling right now?
No, they
you
can't. Know? They can't.
They have to.
No, you
it's
can't
strong
smell yourself.
Sometimes.
You
it's
can't.
Really
you have to
strong.
Really make an effort to smell yourself. And even then, you don't smell as bad to you as you smell as bad to everyone else.
It is. Yeah, it's pretty bad. And I wish that there was a natural way of taking care of it, but none of that natural stuff works.
It
you
doesn't. That's
to,
what I hear. I use chemicals in everything. I eat unhealthy. Now I'm pretty healthy, but I eat junk, whatever. I'm not worried. Like, everyone's so tight.
Yeah, and it's funny because all these people.
And we have to save the planet. I understand that, and I recycle sometimes.
Look,
but
you're not going to live forever, and I know it's probably going to prolong your life a bit more. But what kind of life is there if you're always worried about things? You know.
I know. You got to have some fun, man. Life
yeah,
is
and again,
rough.
It's going to probably affect your dating life incredibly.
Exactly. He's going to lose another model. So I worry about him. Okay, Katy Perry biopic is on the way. Can't get enough of Katy and Russell drama? If you can hold out to 2013, all your dreams will be answered. In the film Katy Perry, Part of Me, it's a 3D biographical film that promises to dish out all the dirt on the star's failed marriage. Perry's upcoming album is also rumored to unleash a lot of Katy's pent-up Russell rage.
Why would she have pent-up Russell rage? Why does
I don't
she
know, because she doesn't like the way he handled the divorce.
Well, it might be a little bit of karma because her ex before him was so hung up on her. Like, he's still affected
really?
About her. Like, she kind of just broke up with him, and this guy was, like, super in love with her. And it was very public on how broken up this guy was
wow,
about her.
Wow, I don't remember this.
His name is Travie McCoy. He sings in Gym Class Heroes. He's actually a really popular singer. He has like a bunch of hits on the radio right now. And a lot of songs were like about her, and he heavily got into, I'm not saying that it really happened, that he got into drugs. I mean, I know that he smokes a lot of weed because he's very public about that. But, you know, maybe it's karma. If you treat people a certain way, it's going to come back at you.
Is that true? I'm going to get in a lot of trouble one day.
A lot of karma?
A lot of dudes, I heavily
believe in karma a lot. I believe in karma.
Yeah?
Like if you treat people a certain way or you do things.
I do too. I try to be a good person in the world, but I have hurt a lot of men in my past. Not on purpose, but just breaking
it's because
up with
them. It's because of your past.
It's because of my past has ruined everything. I know. My past has ruined my life. But no, I've broken up with a lot of men that I know I just wasn't ready to move to the next level and get married or whatever, mm-hmm. or move in together. So
and they
I,
were heartbroken over
They
it.
Were heartbroken, but they all move on. Everyone moves on. It's
yeah.
fine. But I think I did it in a really nice way, so I think I still have good karma. I never was mean to anybody. I hope no one's listening right now.
You'd be like, they're going to call in.
She was a bitch. I'm glad no one can call in right now. Okay, so let's move on to some emails. You can always email me at feedback@sexwithemily.com. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Sex with Emily, and you can follow Menace and White Menace in all those places.
Everything. I've got a lot of Sex with Emily listeners been following me on Facebook and Instagram.
Yeah?
Yeah, I love
it. You're so busy on Instagram.
I wish you would follow me on Tumblr too. I promise I'll do more Tumblr updates.
Okay, I need to do my Tumblr updates.
And then we got to do Pinterest, and then
I'm on Pinterest. I'm on Pinterest. I am. Are you?
Yeah, I'm on Pinterest, and I don't really use it.
I don't have time. Who's got time to pin shit all day long?
I don't know, but I'm really into Path, but I can't get any more friends because they have a 150 friend limit. I'm already at my limit, but I really enjoy it. So you guys should download it. You would have fun.
Okay. Sounds good. All right, we got emails. All right, Emily, I'm pretty new to the program and the Emily Morse experience, but I love your show. My first time was pretty recent, New Year's Eve 2010. And as a guy, the vagina that I was in did nothing for me. It was a lousy lay, and of course, I didn't tell her that. But does sex eventually get better? Gordon from Madison, Georgia.
Georgia?
We've been getting a lot of virgins writing lately, or people who are new to sex. Yes, it gets better. I promise you it gets better. I want to know how you know she was so lousy if you've never had sex before.
She was so lousy? He said it was lousy in general.
He said, the vagina that I was in did nothing for me. It was a lousy lay, and of course, I didn't tell her that.
Yeah, that's every vagina in the beginning. You're like, really? That's it? That's what I've been waiting my entire life for?
I don't know how old you are, but exactly. I mean, you're new at it. Sex gets so much better. In fact, that's one of the good things about getting older is that sex actually gets better and better and better, especially for women. But men, too. Yeah. Men, you know, I wouldn't worry about it. It's not supposed to be great the first time. If you had amazing orgasm-inducing crazy sex the first time and you're a woman, let me know. If you're a guy and your first time was great, you can let me know too. Feedback at sexwithemily.com.
I've never heard that from anybody. Like, oh, I had amazing sex my first time.
No,
never.
Just the first time. You get
Everyone
out of the way.
Everyone says it's lame.
Yeah, it's kind of like going to the doctor for child. It's almost like, I don't even know what analogy. I can't think of one right now. But it's just like you got to go through it. It's like a prerequisite to having good sex. Eventually, you got to go through the first time. But it's not supposed to be great.
Yeah. And then just, you know, find some chick that has some experience to show you a couple things and then move on to the next one.
Yeah. Date an older woman, maybe.
A lot of guys I know that dated older women. Just a whore.
Yeah. Just date some whore. Don't do that, Gordon. It'll get better, I promise. Okay. Long distance relationships. Emily, I love your show. This is my first time writing in. My boyfriend of 1 year is a new medical resident. I understand he's busy, but lately I've been resentful that he hasn't been reinforcing me in our long-distance relationship, Hawaii to the mainland. A month ago, I told him it would be nice to have more support. He said he does not believe in doing things to be romantic, and guys shouldn't set the bar too high for the future. Instead of making crazy demands,
He says he does not believe in doing things to be romantic and guys shouldn't set the bar too high for the future. Instead of making crazy demands, I've gone out of my way to show through example how nice it is to have someone go out of their way for you, i.e. I send him a care package, I text with a few reasons they're important to you. It's gotten me nowhere. How do I bring this up in a way that seems reasonable? This is from Emily, another Emily from Honolulu, Hawaii.
So this is a chick doing this to a guy.
Yeah, and they're in a long-distance relationship and she wants him to be romantic and do things so that she knows that he has feelings for her when they're apart. And I think that he's got to step it up a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, guys don't really think this stuff is too sentimental as you want them to think it is. You know, when a girl sends me a card or send me some things, I go, oh, yeah, that's cool. You know, but if it was reversed where a guy was sending it to a girl, like she'd be like, oh, my God. She would think it was so sweet and she would probably call her girlfriends and say how amazing it was. She'd probably tag a photo of it on Facebook
and
tell everybody. But guys just don't do that. I mean, you shouldn't really take it too much to the heart, but
I want to know exactly what she wants. So she sent him a care package and text with all the reasons she likes him. But what do you think? I think it's a compromise here, Emily, that she's going to look at what would he be willing to do? Like, it sounds like he's not the care package guy. He doesn't like romantic, silly things. But what would really make you feel good? Do you just need him to say nicer things to you when you're on the phone, the compliments? Or do you need him to be like, I miss you? Is he not even using that language? Because a lot of women feel good about that. Like, if you're in a long-distance relationship, you want to hear, like, I miss you, I care about you. But not every guy's into the care package thing.
Yeah.
So maybe you're not – I don't know. I wonder if you're getting the verbal reinforcement that you need. I wonder if that's enough because you can't force a guy to do something like this.
Yeah. I kind of want to go to Hawaii right now.
But how hard is it for a guy to send flowers? Me too. I need a beach vacation. I haven't had one in years.
I need some sun.
Me too. Mexico.
No.
We're so close.
I'll end up in a Mexican prison. There's no way.
Probably. Ended up in Disney prison, so you might as well end up in Mexican prison.
No way. I don't want to go to Mexican prison. No way.
But I would
be
say
in prison
that
so quick. But
she can bring it up. Okay, so wait. She asks me, how do I bring this up in a way that seems reasonable? Well, I think, Emily, that you should have a talk with him and say, you know what, I'm really feeling like, and you should really spend some time thinking about exactly what you need. Because maybe you're feeling like he doesn't miss you as much, or he's not matching your emotions. So think about what you need and what would make you feel good. If you really do think you need flowers once a month or you need something, I mean, I have a lot of, I'm not like this, but I have plenty of girlfriends who were like, would tell guys, like, I need to feel special. You need to do something for me. And one of my best friends tell this guy that she's like, he's like, you need to like buy me flowers or buy me jewelry or like do something that makes you feel special every once in a while. And they would start to do it. So I think you could just say, I want to feel special. And these are the things that it's important to me, and tell them.
Yeah.
But really go deep and figure out what it is that you're lacking. Is it really the flowers, or is it more like reinforcement?
And I heard dating Hawaii is terrible.
Really?
My assistant, she lived in Hawaii for 2 years, and she's like, There's only like a couple hundred people you could date, and everybody slept with each other. It's like San Francisco.
It's like San Francisco.
Problem is, the thing was with San Francisco, you can go outside the city and date if you want to. But you're
stuck on
the island.
Is that what you do? Is that all these girls you're boning? Are they from the East Bay? South Bay?
East Bay?
South Bay?
East Bay, South Bay? All around the Bay. It's like, except for North Bay.
I sleep with girls all around the Bay.
Not North Bay.
Not North Bay? Nothing? No one from Marin? Why not?
Because I'm telling you,
those bitches from Marin, I don't even want to hear it.
People that are
not from the Bay Area.
Not from the Bay Area, if you're listening. We have the East Bay, the South Bay, and the North Bay. And I just don't go in the North Bay. North Bay is Napa, Marin, all that stuff.
Beautiful.
It's very beautiful. It's just a different vibe, different type of people.
Yeah, I get it. I get it.
You know, and it's just not me.
It's not your peeps.
It's not my people.
But you're banging girls who are mostly out of the city. Don't live in the city.
Yeah, are originally from that area.
Got it.
Like, no.
Okay, just curious.
I don't
that's
date
the only
anybody.
Information we're gonna
get. I know, but also I don't date anybody that's just recently moved to San Francisco.
No, right?
Because they have to go and do all the, you know, I just moved to San Francisco. I got to go hang out in Dolores Park and get
Dolores
drunk.
Dolores Park is fun.
It is fun, but it's just like people come here and when they move here and. They just do the same things, like, oh, I'm going to get into...
What's wrong with that? What if you want to go to the Golden Gate Bridge?
Yeah, that's cool, but the thing is...
Alcatraz.
It's not... I want to really know who they are. It's just like, people just follow the same pattern when they move here from another state.
They do?
Yeah, I'm gonna go hang out in the Mission for a while and be a Mission hipster. And then after that, you know what? I'm going to go bro it up in the Marina of San Francisco. You know? They usually pick a neighborhood.
Every neighborhood has their own personality in San Francisco.
Yeah.
So I think that people usually pick a neighborhood and stick to it. No?
No. I think people progress and they go through different phases. And I would like to meet them at the end of their phases.
I have a friend who will not date anybody who lives in certain neighborhoods. Do you have that? He's like, I won't date a Marina chick. Like, anyone who lives in the Marina, he won't. He's like, if she tells me she lives in the Marina, I'm not interested anymore.
No, I don't.
You don't do that? You don't know?
I know. They do have different personalities, though.
For sure. People
that you date in between.
For sure. Okay. Sexually moving on after a relationship. Dear Emily, so a couple of months ago, I got out of a 4-year relationship. My only sexual relationship. I love sex, but I'm nervous about sexually moving on. Is this normal? I mean, it's probably cliche, but I never planned to have sex with more than him. Kind of exciting to try something new now, though, because he was really small. What's your opinion? From Savan. She's from Modesto, California. She's a premium Friends with Benefits member.
The 209. I love
209.
Modesto.
Okay. 4-year relationship. Okay, it's totally normal to be nervous about moving on sexually, especially if this was your first guy that you were with. But if you're excited, you know, I know that you said you didn't plan on having sex with more than him, but that's what you think when you're young and you're having sex for the first time. But you're excited for something new. He was kind of small. Just wait till you get out there and you see other penises. They're not all really small. There's some big ones or some wide ones. You can just go experience penises. But let me tell you, that Savan, it's totally fine to be nervous. Don't jump into it till you're ready. Don't let anyone force you into having sex. And just stick with yourself and don't
find a bigger penis.
Find a bigger penis.
It's rough
out.
That's
the good news.
I know
downside,
her
downside small penis, upside new relationship, bigger penis maybe.
I know her area very well. I have a lot of friends that live out there.
What's their penises like?
I don't know their penises, but that area is actually, you're 20 something, you got a kid. Or you you know, you've been in jail a couple of times. It's like the dating out there is kind of rough.
Okay.
Yeah,
I didn't know that. She's a Friends Benefits member.
So Godspeed.
Good luck to you, Savan. Maybe you should move to San Francisco and sleep with people who are a bunch of hipsters. All right. Let's call our guest.
Okay.
Barbie Davenporte. She's a writer for the Village Voice Media sex blog After Dark LA, and she's got some crazy embarrassing sex stories, and she knows all about sex, sex toys. We're going to talk to her in a minute. And she, yeah, she's a writer for After Dark LA. She's got sex stories. Like, for example, she had a threesome with a gay guy and an engaged dude. Yes, it's possible. Wow. That's one of her titles.
Okay. Hold on. We'll call her up real quick. We just got to... Damn, I just called it. Sorry. Try again. How'd you even hook up with this?
We hooked up with her through... you know who we hooked up with through with up with her through? My co-author of my book, Hot Sex, which I haven't talked about lately. I wrote a book with Jamie Waxman called Hot Sex, Over 200 Things You Can Try Tonight, and you can buy it on Amazon right now. And she introduced us, and she thought that Barbie would be a great guest, and here we have it.
All right. Well, we're calling her right now.
Let's do it.
Hello?
Hey, Barbie. It's Emily. I'm good. How are you?
You're on the radio.
You're on the radio. You're on live right now with me and Menace.
I basically live my life as if I'm always on the radio. Okay. So
I love it.
You didn't have to tell me.
I didn't even have to tell you. It wouldn't even matter. You'd be the same person. Okay, so
totally.
So Barbie, so excited. We've been reading your blog, and we know that you've got or your stories on AfterDarkLA.com, which are great. And then you also say you have embarrassing sex stories, which some of them you write about. So what is your what's your go-to most embarrassing story? Because we haven't heard anything yet.
It's kind of hard to choose because it really depends on who the audience is. Because, you get those sort of embarrassing stories involving bodily fluids, and you're like, nah, I don't know if I want to really share those. But the one that always comes to mind was I happened to fornicate with a porn star a couple years ago. No big deal.
Right.
But I really wanted to make it my mission to sort of show him, that I'm the BJ queen.
Right, of
course. Even though, and he's been blown by dudes and girls, and I really just was convinced that I could show him that, hey, they can just, jump
right,
in the lake.
Right, of course.
My mouth is like a fucking Hoover, yeah. So I go for it, and it's all good, doing well. I've happened to be pretty good at it, so I'm told.
Right.
And I go for the, oft-forgotten area of the ball region.
Right.
And put one in my mouth, and then he jumps up, jolts and yelps, almost kicks me in the face as if I had maybe, just shoved something up his butt.
Right.
Or, set his pad on fire. It was so bizarre. And so meanwhile, I'm still there, and, the left ball is hanging out of my mouth.
Right, of course.
And I'm looking at him, with my mouth full, is everything okay? what's going on? And he just looks at me and goes, oh, I'm just a little sensitive. And I look at him are you fucking kidding me? I'm just a little blonde.
Right.
You're really fucking sensitive. You almost knocked my expensive teeth out.
Right.
So, but I really, I had already followed through. And so I gently removed it from my mouth and then went for the other. And then really just, I guess my own stubborn nature, I just kind of kept going. And every time I would touch his balls, he'd kind of kick me in the face a little, and
wow,
I kept going because it was if I had left, I would have failed my mission.
Exactly. No, you had to take it through fruition.
Yeah, but some guys just don't like their balls.
Some guys don't like their balls touched. Menace doesn't like his balls touched, and I've tried.
Really?
Yeah,
no, I haven't tried. But
everyone else I ever talked to is oh my god, what the fuck? We touched my balls.
It does
Menace,
nothing.
But Menace is weird. So Menace is not your normal guy.
Hold on.
What?
Of course, if you tell a guy, I want to touch your balls, I'm oh, yeah, go ahead, touch my balls. You can't get an honest opinion. Just not every single guy is into it. That's all.
Yeah, but he's a porn star. Isn't that a prerequisite? Balls touch, check.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter if he's a porn star. It doesn't mean he does everything.
Yeah, it does.
Oh,
doesn't
does
it mean
it?
If you're a porn star, you do everything? Okay.
No, totally true.
Right?
I get it.
You get it. You're you, of all people, would like your balls sucked. So you finally gave him a killer BJ, though, right? Even except for the little ball incident.
We did it a bunch of times. And then I let him have sex with me a few times just because.
Was he good? What was that?
My bucket list.
Exactly.
He was good. I mean, he's definitely good. It was more I was looking up at him being I'm having sex with this guy who looks kind of like an Adonis statue, but is goofy, and I'm just, this is just weird. And it was a little bit strange because you were always wondering, like, is he kind of performing right now? Or
right.
Is he really into this?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. That's what I would be wondering. I'm like, he's really into it, but whatever. But if he was good, I guess I wouldn't care, and I'd just take my ego out of it and pretend that he was really into it because he was really good.
Yeah, I totally took the ego out.
Exactly.
It's like at the end of the day. You're getting banged, and you're probably going to have an orgasm. Like, that's the goal, and that's cool.
Exactly. So that's good. Okay, what else is on your bucket list that you've crossed off?
That I have crossed off?
Yeah, I don't know. Just what other stories?
Well, I ended up, let's see. Well, I did the gay porn star thing, because he was sort of like, he swung both ways.
Okay, so he's bisexual. Yeah, done.
I managed to, and it was a total accident, have a sort of three-way with an older gay man and an engaged straight dude.
Wow.
Which is terrible, but I was already going to hell a long time ago.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
Yeah, and it was just one of those things where really just trace amounts of booze were involved, and one of them was totally sober, so there's no excuses.
Right.
The gay dude really got off on the idea of watching the straight dude go to town on a straight girl.
Right.
And when he met me, like, apparently I fulfilled his entire, like, she's the one, totally.
Wow.
And then we happened to be in one room, the three of us together, talking about something, like, business related, which was not sexy in any way. And then thighs were touched, and then this happened, and then blah. And so, like, that was off the list. And then at the same time, I also sort of had a little thing on my bucket list of, like, being sort of a in power, like dom situation,
right,
but without violence or pain. And basically, like, the two dudes ended up sitting next to each other on the bed, like, just watching me not do anything even remotely sexual. I just kind of, like, stared at them a lot. And
right.
I did take my top off, whatever, but I didn't touch one of them. Or either of them, and, like, they both did their thing, and so all I did was, like, stare them in the eye.
Wow, so right, cool. Right. So that is so cool. That's awesome. So what do you think about the fact that you write about sex? I mean, I talk about sex. You write about sex. Do people mm-hmm. feel like – do you feel like men or women, whoever you're with, have certain expectations of you? Like, well, how do you deal with that? Because I find it to be
totally.
Kind of – right? They're like, oh, sex with Emily, so you're going to sleep with me now, and you're probably a prostitute and whatever, and, you know. So how do you deal with that? Because I don't know what the hell to do. I'm just
honestly,
dating, yeah.
It's really just, it's open, I don't know, everyone always says this, like, it's open communication and also being very willing to say, go get the fuck out if
right.
they end up sort of crossing a line. And I honestly don't even mean that in a sexual way. What has happened a few times on the dating scene is one dude saw my Facebook page, which really has a lot of articles I've written. A lot of it has to do with sex ed and sexual health, but he approached me and was like, hey, what's with all the kinky sex shit on your Facebook page? And immediately I should have been like, TTYL, but I didn't, because he was kind of attractive, so we hadn't even gone out yet. So I explained, it's not kinky sex stuff, it's actually education-based if you read it.
Right, exactly.
And then he goes, wait a minute, does that mean you're some kinky sex freak? And then I was like, and I still should have said fuck off, but I
right.
didn't. So I explained, well, no, it's my job, and I'm a journalist, and this is my topic of choice. And then he goes, well, then wait a minute, what's your take on monogamy? And then boom, like, explosion. You're an idiot.
Right, good.
Immediately, because this was the topic I chose about. I was untrustworthy. I was, polyamorous and totally irresponsible and crazy and some kinky, you know,
right.
freako who does God knows what, you know.
Emily, you still would have went out with him.
I would have gone out with him, maybe, by mistake. I would just probably date him for 6 months. I've been like, okay, here's my number. And then I would have been like, I really never liked him. And then date him for 6 months. But that's my problem. Yeah.
I've been there, Emily. I understand. Like, what I ended up doing was saying, you know, I'm not even interested in meeting with you. The fact that I'm already defending something I just shouldn't have to defend.
The red flags are there.
Meeting you.
Right.
But then, like, 7 months later, he managed to convince me to go on a hike with him and meet face to face and, like, talk it out. And he ended up being this very overweight, like, lump. And I out-hiked him, and he was, you know, sweating the whole time and trying to sort of almost defend himself and make it seem like he had reason to believe those things. And I look at him like, are you fucking joking? Damn it. We're on the side of a mountain.
Right.
And it'd be homicide if I kicked him.
Right.
He'd totally fall.
Right. Exactly. You got to be careful of that.
So
who goes hiking on a date?
Kept going.
Who goes hiking on a date?
Oh, Menace is anti-hiking date.
Like, that's so...
like, that's all Mendes got out of that. He's like, he's just like, really? You made someone hike?
You went on
a people hike.
Date?
I used to go on hiking dates.
That's so weird. I think that's
weird. Why is that weird? People do it all the time.
I think that's like so,
you get
like...
You exercise. You get to look at birds.
I think that's like, oh, I'm going to bury you in the middle of the fucking forest.
That's
type
true.
Shit.
Maybe not a blind date hiking. I don't know.
Yeah, blind date hiking is a bad idea. That's
blind
like
date,
blind
exactly.
Date,
don't do a blind date hiking. That's okay. If you learned anything from the Sex Family Show, you learned that today. So what about, you also write a lot about sex toys. So what are some of your new favorite toys out there? Anything we haven't heard of? Or anything new coming around the bend that I should own right now?
Honestly, yeah. There's something that I haven't even received yet, but I've done so much writing and I have so much... I have so many colleagues in that side of the industry who have just been raving about it that I can't wait for mine to come in the mail. It's called Fixation.
Okay.
It's F-I-X-S as in Sam, Asian. And it's basically a clitoral vibrator that you wear while you have intercourse.
Oh, cool.
But it's just something so unlike all the bullshit, like jelly butterfly ugly things that you can buy at novelty stores.
Right,
like
right.
No pink gummy little bug that's supposed to be cute. It's just a really effective ergonomically shaped bean that is held onto you using lingerie like belts. So it's like a little lace belt.
Oh, that's
that
cool.
Really,
so it's, it'll stay in place. Right. That's cool.
Yeah,
oh,
exactly.
I've never heard of it. Okay. That, I love it. I've never heard of that one because there are like the Wii vibe. It's supposed to be like the couples vibrator you can use during sex, but I like that this one just stays on and stays in place. Then you go to your business.
Yeah, yeah. The problem, there are lots of problems with some of these dual-use vibrators because they assume every woman is the same size and shape,
right,
and therefore it should work. And often that stuff never ends up hitting the spot you need it to hit.
Exactly.
And at the end of the day, the spot you really need to hit is your clit.
Right.
And, it, you know, who gives a shit about the G-spot, honestly, because you can angle yourself and have, you know, assuming that the dick is in there and it's
right,
hard, it'll hit your G-spot on its own. So these types of items are really useful because they don't move and they don't get in the way because they're really
That
thin
is so cool. Okay, when you
lot
get one, you got to tell us how it goes. Oh, I'm going to get one too. We'll just
totally
I'm excited. Okay, what else? Anything else? What is this rock box that you were talking about? Does something really exist that's strong? You wrote about this.
The rock box. That's another crazy thing. I haven't tried it and I'm actually not interested in trying it only because I am not at the point where I need that much power in order to get off.
Okay, but you're so lucky. I was thinking it sounds good. More powerful than the Hitachi Magic Wand?
See, that's what
it's
I'm saying.
It's so much more powerful.
That's
the whole deal.
That's why I'm very hesitant with the sex toys because I just feel like...
And his balls.
You know, you're just going to need to go bigger and bigger and bigger. It's like a
well,
drug.
No.
It's like a drug.
It's like a gateway.
It
sounds like if I get the rock box, the walls are so thin in my apartment building that like my neighbors would think there was like an earthquake or something. They already do with
everyone,
the Hitachi.
Yeah,
so that's scary.
It's so loud. It is so powerful, but it really is so effective for women who find that most women love the wand. The Hitachi wand is like their, you know, second little adoptive child,
right,
whatever. And they, you know, keep it safe and keep it close. And this is sort of like, it looks like a power tool minus the sharp object at the end of the power tool.
Oh, my God.
And I know. And it has this sort of silicone tongue-like attachment that just, it's thick, but it's the motor is so powerful that even the thick silicone starts to wiggle and wobble.
Okay.
And there's like, I think 5 or 6 speeds, and the 6th speed, there are videos online. Actually, there's a video on my site because I wrote about this. It goes so, it's so powerful that the woman's holding it in her hand and it's practically jumping from hand to hand.
Oh my God. That sounds like too, that's crazy.
It
that
sounds like
too
you're
much
explaining like an engine for like a crane or something like
yeah
that.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I kind of am.
Yeah, exactly. Can you buy, okay, so what else is coming out that you can buy? You know, one of our sponsors is Good Vibrations, so lots mm-hmm of toys you can buy at goodvibrations.goodvibes.com, and you use coupon code GVEmily15 for 15% off most purchases from Good Vibes. So what can someone buy? What's some more mainstream things that is out right now that you're loving?
No, some more mainstream. Well, I was going to say something that is starting to become more mainstream friendly. I don't know if you've heard of, you know, electrostimulation or electricity.
A little bit. Yeah, I have. I have. Of course. Yeah.
It's something that, it's very kinky and it looks really creepy and kind of scary. But there's a company that came out with something called the Twilight Wand, and they made it really easy to just have, it's like a longer wand made of glass. And at the very end of the glass tip, it just sort of sends out a little bit of a static electricity shock.
Okay.
And it really just feels like a little tap. just like how a vibrator hits you.
Oh.
It's literally hitting your skin with an offset motor. And what this Twilight wand does is it just hits your skin with a different kind of stimulation. And it's really easy to make it super light or more of a heavier feeling.
Right.
And it feels just like little tingles. And there's a really comfortable handle and a really easy to control.
Cool.
Setting. So couples are actually using it together because a lot of the times couples are sort of like, I'm looking for the next thing.
Exactly.
And, you know, the next
electricity.
Level of sensation.
It's a way to do it in your own home.
Which is
super
cool.
That's awesome. Cool.
Like, even though, and for mainstream stuff, like regular vibrators, for women who really need a lot of power and love their Hitachis, but it's kind of loud and they're kind of obnoxious looking.
Yes.
Juju, which is this really cool British company, you might be familiar.
Yes.
I know Good Vibes likes them. They have something called the Mimi, which is a little pebble vibrator, and it's seamless, and it looks very sort of stylish and high-tech modern. It's got a really powerful motor, and I forget how many settings, but I think 4 or 5 different levels with some pulsations, and that'll definitely get the job done. And
oh,
it's
good.
So smooth and handheld that it's really nice against your body. So you could even use it on muscles, on honestly the underside of the balls, the underside of the shaft. I know many
if
who really like
someone's it. Someone's a ball guy. Yeah, the Mimi. Okay, that's cool. Check it out. I like Juju. They make those Kegel balls too. The Kegel.
Yeah,
I have
the
an app.
The
Omni balls, exactly. I have one of those. I keep meaning to use those balls. Okay, thank you so much, Barbie. You're awesome.
Of course.
Tell me, people can find you at AfterDarkLA.com.
Yeah, and they can find me on Twitter at B Davenport, or AfterDarkLA is also on Twitter, and I'm on Facebook, and I'll answer any questions you've got as long as they're appropriate and well-worded. You have to use good grammar.
Okay, perfect. We'll have this all on our website as well. Thank you so much, Barbie.
Cool.
We'll talk to you soon.
Of course. Thanks for having me.
Go have more stories you can share. Go do some other stuff that you can share with us.
Oh, I'll start thinking. Let me
start
know when
thinking.
You want me to tell
okay,
you more.
Okay, perfect. Okay, bye, Barbie. Have a good day.
Bye.
Okay.
Yeah,
Barbie Davenport.
Really
she's got
good.
Some
I
good sex
her.
Stories. I know. Isn't she awesome? She's hilarious. And she's a great writer. You got to check out her blog on AfterDarkLA. .com. You should ask her how she makes a living. You were going to ask her that.
I was,
if I let you get a word Ned-wise.
Yeah. She's
I didn't really do that.
Walking.
Okay. So,
Walking and talking.
Okay. So that's what we got for you today on Sex with Emily. Anything else you'd like to add, Menace?
Yes. We're here at the Sister Studios in San Francisco, California. If you want to listen to the show on your mobile device, your smartphone, your Android, your iPhone, they have iPad app.
Yep.
There is a desktop version, which I don't know if it's too public yet. But download the app. It's totally free. And then once you download the app, you just search Sex with Emily and you can listen to Sex
exactly.
with Emily on the go.
And you should become a Friends with Benefits member. We do 3 shows a week. You get lots of perks, even more perks coming. It's $4.95 a month. It's like 23 cents a day. And we totally appreciate everyone who supports, though. Because if you're listening to the show, we need your support. We're giving you better sex. So we appreciate it.
You feel me?
You feel me?
All right.
Okay, everyone. Thanks for listening to Sex with Emily. Was it good for you? Email me feedback@sexwithemily.com.